Hello?
Hello? Hello?
I got nothing.
Nothing? Nothing? Hello?
Hello. Hey, there we go. All right, before we get started, there's lots of open seats in the middle. If anybody could just raise their hand that you have some seats next to you, because there's people in the back that are standing and there's so many seats in the middle down here. So if you have some seats and you want to sit, we'll give you a couple more minutes. If you guys want to get out of that back and sit down, there are seats. I see them.
Good evening. Please remain standing for the Star Spangled Banner. You may be seated. Before we get started tonight, because the ceremony is inside, I would like everybody to please take note of the emergency exits. There's two exits on the back wall and then two exits on this wall as well. Welcome, honored students, families, faculty, guests, Board of Education, to the Granville Junior Senior High School graduation ceremony. I have had the privilege of getting to know this class over this past several years. Sitting in front of you today, I see students who are moving on to the next chapter in their lives. And I would like to share some of their accomplishments that they've had with us. Some of our students have gone to the World Vex Robotics numerous years in a row. Others have traveled the country for the FFA competitions. This class has done countless volunteer hours. We have 26 of our graduates going on to four-year colleges and 34 going on to two-year programs, while several are going directly into the workforce. Some have never missed a day of school, while others have excelled in athletics at the state competition level. And many have overcome tremendous odds to complete their high school diploma. I hope that we have been able to help each of you achieve your goals, make it through the rough times that come with growing up, and in some way help you celebrate your successes, lives, and futures. As this chapter of your life ends, a new adventure is awaiting you. I hope that the following thoughts in some way help you unfold your story and it becomes the greatest story ever told for each one of you. Believe in yourself. Please do not let your fears overwhelm your desire. Let the barriers you face, and there will be barriers, be external and not internal. I promise that you will never know what you are capable of unless you try. Find your passion in life. If you've not found your passion in life yet, you will find it later, maybe in your 20s, your 30s or 40s. Never give up and always remember to follow it. Remember that the important things are those that fill you from the inside and fill your heart. Take control of your life. As your story unfolds, the first thing you should do is throw away that map that someone else gave you. Your time is limited. Don't waste it living someone else's dreams. Pain and disappointment are inevitable, but suffering is optional and tough times are always temporary. Live life honestly. Listen to both your head and your heart. Act. Don't wait to be invited. Create opportunities and live them. Life will happen to you, whether you try to guide it or not. So you might as well try to influence the outcome. Please do not sacrifice 1,000 tomorrows for a few todays. Live with a purpose and for significance. Respect your others, avoid self-righteousness, and be kind rather than right. Remember to always follow your heart. The key is to listen to your heart and let it carry you in the direction of your dreams. Each day that you are moving toward your dreams without compromise who you are, you are winning. So with all this in mind, Take time to dream big. As dreams help you do great things, large and small, continue to learn, be curious, be open to others that have interests that differ from you. Take responsibility for your successes and your failures. Be resilient and learn from your mistakes and celebrate your accomplishments. As you sit here together as a class for the very last time, I encourage you to focus on what you have learned and accomplished in and outside of school. Use this knowledge and experience to your advantage. Finally, tonight, more than any other night, remember to be grateful. Express your gratitude today, particularly to your parents, teachers, and fellow students, all who have helped you bring you to this threshold of life. And as you leave here today, you'll be receiving a journal, one in which you should write the next chapter of your great journey. I do hope that your dreams take you to the corners of your smiles, to the highest of your hopes, to the windows of your opportunities, and to the most special places your heart has ever known. Congratulations, guys. And now the senior band will play a selection.
Thank you.
Please help me welcome salutatorian Sophie Mae Scott.
We all know the song, Don't Stop Believing by Journey. We've heard it on the radio, sang to it with friends at school dances, and some of us have even danced to it at Spirit Night this year. Maybe we sing to it because it's a catchy tune. Maybe because we can relate to it. We live in a small town with a population of approximately 2,500 people. Our graduating class has 95 students, while more populated schools could have upwards of 500 students per graduating class. We are lucky to be able to go to a school this size, and we are lucky to live in a small community because we have so many opportunities that people living in larger areas do not have. Small communities support each other when and celebrate the happy times together. Granville has always been our engine, our driving force, pulling us through the curves on the tracks of life to get to where we are today. At Granville High School, every student knows each other. It's not uncommon for a seventh or eighth grader to greet a senior in the hall as they pass each other. Our small school allows younger students to have role models to look up to. During basketball season in fifth and sixth grade, we were able to practice with varsity, and I remember all of us thinking that these varsity girls were the coolest people ever. In big schools, opportunities for younger students to know older students do not occur. Because of the size of our school, we could get a chance to know our entire class at a personal level. When we were younger, we were able to form close relationships with each other because there weren't many kids in the school. For example, when we were in third grade, a friend and I decided that in our senior year, we were going to have a jalapeno eating contest. And it did happen about 3 weeks ago, and it was as terrible as you think. The experiences we have had with each other have helped us become the people we are today. The friends we have made at this school are ones that will be with us through the rest of our lives, maybe not physically, but at least in our memories. Of course, knowing each other personally is not the only advantage of a small school. The teachers at our school are able to learn our names, build relationships with us, and push us to strive towards our goals. Throughout the years we have been in high school, we have had the pleasure of getting to know many different teachers. Some we have had for only a year, some we have had for 4 years. The teachers at this school have devoted countless hours after school to their students in order to help them succeed and achieve their future goals. I have never heard of any teachers devoting as much time to their students as the teachers at Granville have. In high school, teachers learn our future goals and help us accomplish them by staying after class to give us the extra assistance we may need. They also encourage us on a more personal level. And it's not only high school teachers that are devoted to their students. I am positive that there are at least a few grade school teachers here to watch their former students walk across our stage to receive their diploma. A great school is only the product of a great community. Small towns support all its community members. The town of Granville has shown time and time again that when one of our own is faced with hardships, we will band together to help the community member. I know from personal experience that when I went through a rough time, the community was there to lend a helping hand and a bright smile to help me push through. Our town not only supports people who are in need of help, they push our community members to succeed. The bleachers in our gym have been filled only on a number of reasons. When we have a school-wide assembly or we have a boys basketball team game. Community members filled the stands every game the boys had this year, and some even followed them to their games at other schools. At the Glens Falls Civic Center, students, parents, and community members alike cheered the boys on, being by far the loudest group there. Our community has taught us to be selfless and connected to others around us, which are two traits we will carry on through the rest of our lives. The past is over, and we only have the future ahead of us, but the past experiences we have had here in Granville will forever shape us. This year, the class of 2017 will be boarding our midnight trains, leading out of the school and onto the train tracks of life. I would like to invite any of the teachers who have helped shape us to come up and help our class advisors unroll our senior train. Seniors. Seniors, always remember this. No matter where life takes you, whether it's UVM, Binghamton, Jacksonville University, or ACC, know that your hometown is behind you, supporting you every step of the way. The train tracks of life will always lead you back to the Granville station. Thank you.
Now please help me welcome the members of the senior class to do a selection for us.
Time of our life. but always remember.
Everybody now!
Together, 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 everyone. Together, together, come on, let's have some fun. Together, we're there for each other every time. Together, together, come on, let's do this right. Here and now, it's time for celebration. I finally figured it out. Yeah, yeah, that all our dreams have no limitations. That's what it's all about. Come on now, everyone is special in their own way. We make each other strong, we're not the same, we're different in a good way. Together's where we belong, we're all in this together. Once we know that we are, we're all stars, and we see that we're all in this together. And it shows when we stand hand in hand, make our dreams come true. Woo!
Please help me in welcoming the class officers for their presentations.
It takes a very special kind of passion to be a teacher. You must have an inexhaustible supply of patience, a desire to impart your wisdom onto others, and above all, a willingness to learn alongside your students. For many of us, we've had teachers for the past 4 years, or teachers whom we've been on countless trips with, or those who are advisors and coaches in activities outside of school. They've taken part in our various passions, witnessed moments of angst, and watched the evolution of our character for the past 4 years. Many of us have rented out spaces in Mr. Harden's room on countless late nights. Maybe you've gone to Ms. Becker in a state of panic, seeking not only her organizational help, but also some comic relief. Perhaps you've walked into Mr. Wheeler's outfit or had a conversation about something you want to accomplish and complimented on your complete attention and unconditional support. Maybe the highlight of your day is Mr. Cozy's snack time, or having a philosophical conversation with Mr. Marsfelder that leaves your head spinning. Perhaps Mr. Lambert's menagerie of stuffed animals, or Mrs. Kilby singing to a song she just heard on the radio, brought a smile to your face. Many of our teachers have come to every home game, and even some of our away games. They have provided us with advice beyond their subject areas, helping us to discover our strengths and even to explore possible majors and career paths. Our teachers have been active in supporting our passions both inside and outside of the classroom. They've played a huge role in creating a learning environment where we're not only able to improve ourselves and widen our breadth of knowledge, but truly call a second home. On behalf of the class of 2017, we'd like to thank our teachers. You are appreciated beyond what words can express.
So I was instructed to prepare a speech thanking the parents of the class of 2017. However, I would like to extend this sincere appreciation and acknowledge a wider range of people than that. I would like to thank our guardians and those who have stood by us through this wild journey called high school.
These individuals include your grandparents, your aunts, your uncles, your siblings, and your cousins. Also, to our coaches and teachers, thank you. Thank you for helping us through the rough times and sharing in our countless positive memories. Thank you for your support in preparing us for tests such as the Regents or SATs. And thank you for your encouragement as we pursued our various extracurricular endeavors. These clubs and sports have provided many of us with a realm in which we have truly thrived. Thank you for helping us attain this great milestone, which we are all here to celebrate this evening. High school is a confusing time for us all. It's a time where we begin to better understand the world as well as each other. It's a time defined by many lessons that have combined to make us who we are today. It's a time of many tears and laughter, a time of losses and successes, but most importantly, it's a time where we discover our true identities. Somewhere between all of the lessons and losses, individuals, each possessing our own unique set of morals. Throughout all of these experiences, you have stood by us. There's a popular saying that states, the only person you can depend on is yourself, but that clearly is not true. We are thankful that altruistic people such as yourself have allowed us to depend and lean on you for support. You have all made us grow, and as I look at my classmates in front of me, I see an immense amount of potential and determination to achieve success throughout the years to come. On behalf of the class of 2017, thank you, guardians, and everybody who has stood with us by our journey.
For the past 4 years of our career at Granville High, the class of 2017 has been lucky enough to have had two very special women as our advisors. Not only have these women fulfilled their roles as teachers, they've also gone above and beyond to ensure prosperity within the class of 2017. The dedication they have displayed over the years has not once gone unnoticed. These women have devoted an immense amount of time with our class, from working late nights at the concession stands, holding various class meetings, planning and attending our senior trip, and most importantly, preparing us for this moment. Mrs. Colombo and Miss Becker truly are the dynamic duo. They're looked at as not only our advisors, but also our friends. Their doors are always open, whether you need a sprinkle of optimism from Becker or a humorous remark from Colombo. There is never a dull moment when the two are together, which makes them so enjoyable to be around. On behalf of the senior class, I would like to express how extremely grateful we are to have had the two of you as advisors. Thank you for the dedication, compassion, and endless support you have continuously shown over the years. The class of 2017 would not have been able to finish this journey without you. Thank you.
Our school administration works incredibly hard and diligently year-round to make sure everything runs efficiently. They smooth out or solve any problem we may run into and make opportunities available to us. The Board of Education is made up of people who truly care about the well-being of Granville schools and push them to be the best all around. One thing the board is known for is showcasing the students and schools' respective talents and making sure the community knows that they have produced a bright group of young adults. All of our administration leads by example and are the perfect role models for us to look up to. On behalf of the class of 2017, we'd like to thank all of our administration and the Board of Education for everything that they do for us.
At this time, please help me in welcoming Mr. Mark Judy, Interim Superintendent.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to all of you, to faculty and staff, to parents, to friends and relatives, 2017, to the members of the class. I am delighted to be here on this special occasion. It has been my honor to serve as the interim superintendent since February of this year. When I began several months ago, people that I've known over the years thought this job may be a little more difficult than others. I would be starting in the middle of a school year, and I didn't really know the people. Actually, it didn't turn out that way at all. People in Granville are very cordial, very accommodating. From the very beginning, I felt very much at ease in all the school buildings, but particularly here in the junior-senior high school. I want to thank the class of 2017 for being so welcoming to me from day one. You always met me with a smile and a hello, and when I asked you for directions to certain places in the building, you pointed me in the right direction without laughing. I really appreciated that. And tonight is your special night. For you, it culminates 13 years of school and is a rite of passage to launch you into a new journey of life. For your parents and teachers, it is a time to reminisce about how far you have come and express again their hopes and expectations for your future. To the parent members of the class of 2017, I want to express thanks for entrusting your most precious gifts with us. To the faculty and staff, and I want to acknowledge all district faculty and staff, thank you for creating environments where students are challenged academically. It is through your modeling and personal commitment to student growth and collegiality that makes the Granville School District so very special. And to our distinguished graduates tonight, I hope the road that you choose with your graduation is personally fulfilling and that it brings value to others in this world. Live a life that makes you, your parents, and teachers proud. Be courageous, stand up for what you think is right, be kind and respectful, and stay true to yourself and to your commitments. Congratulations and best wishes to the class of 2017. Thank you.
At this time, we'll go ahead and do the presentation of awards for students. Students, as I call your name, if you could please stand. The following students are the recipient of one award. Becky Hinton, Modern Woodman of America Award. Adam Edwards, Slate Valley Garden Club Award. Abigail Gordon, the Liz C. Freed Family Scholarship Fund Award. Asia Reese, the Granville Central PTA Scholarship. Alexander Burroughs, the Meadowee Valley Ecumenical Council Capstone Project Award. Cheyenne Oakman, the Coach John C. McPhee Scholarship. Marissa Martell, the Knights of Columbus Award. Jonathan Cleveland, the June Laurie Memorial Award. Erica Harwood, the Arnold Paul Goff Memorial Scholarship. Nicholas Edwards, the Dr. Edward J. Kelly Scholarship. Jared Renaud, the Legion Rider Squadron 323rd Granville, New York Military Award. Jamie Dunbar, the Southern Adirondack Substitute Teacher Alliance Scholarship. Jacob Corlew, the Granville Meadowee Valley Senior Citizens Award. Jonathan Amaral, the Michael Craig Campbell Athletic Award. Matthew Dundon, the Knights of Columbus Award. Aaron Mackey, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Athletic Award. John Thomas, the TD Bank Award. Michael Jones, the Legion Riders Squadron 323rd Granville, New York Military Award. Colt Ballard, the Granville Lions Club Award. Carly Goodspeed, the Granville Central School Support Staff Award. Christy St. Marie, the Granville Meadowee Valley Senior Citizens Award. Stephen Baker, the David L. Fisher Music Award. Jeff DeFore, the Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship. Lauren Taylor, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Award. Dakota Zellers, the Legion Riders Squadron 323rd Granville, New York Military Award. George Bork, the Morning Flower Lodge 71 Masonic Scholarship. The following students are the recipients of two awards apiece. Chasley Cozy, the Hyman and Anna Berkowitz Scholarship, and the Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship. Alexis Smith is a recipient of the Harry J. Carroll Memorial Scholarship and the Spirit Club Scholarship. Christina Chilcott is the recipient of the Brenda Smith Memorial Scholarship and the Modern Woodman of America Award. Hollis Paquette is the recipient of the New York State Education Services Scholarship for Academic Excellence and the Spirit Club Scholarship. Michael Liebig is a recipient of the Deborah Tyler Memorial Scholarship and the Liz C. Freed Family Scholarship Fund Award. Haley Gadet is a recipient of the Meadowee Valerie Speech Services Award and the Modern Woodman of America Award. Richard Kelly III is a recipient of the Ed Martin Memorial Award and the Raceville Methodist Church Award. Olivia Haskins is a recipient of the Kyle Shaw Award and the Modern Woodman of America Award. Max Juckett is a recipient of the John Stokowski and Sons Incorporated Award and the Vermont Slate Quarry Association Music Award. Natasha Cooper is a recipient of the New York State Correctional Officers and Police Benevolent Association Incorporated Award and the Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship. Scott Bogart is a recipient of the Modern Woodman of America Award and the Washington County Children's Committee Scholarship Award. Sabrina Bishop is a recipient of the Granville Area Lioness Club's Lena May Tatko Award and the Granville Lions Club Award. The following students are the recipient of three awards. Matthias Karyophilos is a recipient of the Francis Foley Kelly Scholarship, the Granville Lions Foundation Award, and the Hyman and Anna Berkowitz Scholarship. Contessa Selinsky is a recipient of the Citizens Bank Award, the Granville Teacher Association Scholarship, and the Hyman and Anna Berkowitz Scholarship. Molly O'Brien is a recipient of the C. and K. Ellis Academic Achievement Award, the Stanley and Betty Gudlowski Memorial Scholarship, and the Vermont Slate Quarry Association Award. Gabriella Hunt is a recipient of the Isidore Coble Memorial Award, the Carl W. White Scholarship, and the Sheldon Slate Products Incorporated Athletic Award. Cameron Duval is the recipient of the Granville Class of 82 Scholarship Award, the Granville Vet Service and Small Animal Clinic Award, and the Slate Valley Garden Club Award. The following students are the recipient of four awards. Avery Roberts is a recipient of the Granville Central School Administrators Award, the Mildred C. White Scholarship, Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship, and the Stanley and Betty Gudlowski Memorial Scholarship. Jarrett Atori is a recipient of the Curtis Lumber Award, the Hyman and Anna Berkowitz Scholarship, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Athletic Award, and the Norton St. Gobain Future Engineer Award. Morgan Williams is a recipient of the Border Riders Snow Club Award, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Athletic Award, and the Washington County Children's Association. Rachel Bartholomew is a recipient of five awards, the Albert and Berkowitz Community Scholarship, the Glens Falls National Bank Award, the Granville Lions Foundation Award, the Granville Rotary Endowment Fund Award, and the Sigmund Weinberg Scholarship Award. Bailey Daigle is the recipient of the Granville Rotary Club Louis D. Goldberg Memorial Award, the John Falvey Sullivan Fringy VFW Post 1653 Hepper Williams Award, the New York State Education Services Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the Sheldon Slate Products Incorporated Athletic Award, and the Simeon M. Rising Jr. Memorial Masonic Award. The following students are the recipient of six awards. Lauren Bucciero, the American Legion Auxiliary American Government Award, the Granville Area Lioness Club Award, the John Falvey Sullivan Fringy VFW Post 1653 American Award, the Margaret McNally Memorial Scholarship, the Raceville Methodist Church Award, and the Stanley and Betty Gudlowski Memorial Scholarship. Jason Zoll, the Brian M. Douglas Memorial Scholarship, the Daniel Thomas Brill Senior Scholarship, the Hudson Valley Community College Book Award, the Mildred C. White Scholarship, the Richard A. Vogel Memorial Foundation Award, and the Stanley and Betty Gudlowski Memorial Scholarship. Matthew Fuller, the C. and K. Ellis Academic Achievement Award, the Granville Area Chamber of Commerce, Matthew Parker Fisk Memorial Scholarship, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Athletic Award, the Sheldon Slate Products Incorporated Athletic Award, and the Stanley and Betty Gudlowski Memorial Scholarship. The following student is the recipient of seven awards. Trace Bourne, the Fred V. Davison Memorial Masonic Award, the Granville Area Chamber of Commerce, the John Falvey Sullivan Fringy VFW Post 1653 Americanism Award, the Michael Craig Campbell Realty Athletic Award, Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship, Stanley and Betty Godlewski Memorial Scholarship, and the TD Bank Achieve the Dream Scholarship. The following students are the recipient of 8 awards. Brianna Thomas, the American Legion Americanism Award, the American Red Cross Scholarship, the Arch R. Craig Memorial Scholarship, the Border Riders Snowmobile Club Award, the Leo Club Award, the Modern Woodman of America Al Ellis Award, the New York State Education Services Scholarship for Academic Excellence, and the Robert Garrity Memorial Music Award. Seth Bro is the recipient of the Drusil Craig Memorial Scholarship, the FBLA Award, the Granville Lions Foundation Award, the Modern Woodman of America Rod Prevost Award, Norton St. Gobain Good Citizen Award, Operation Adopt a Soldier Incorporated Scholarship, the Slate Valley Garden Club Award, and the Tri-County Branch of Women's National Farm and Garden Association Incorporated Award. Sophie Mae Scott is a recipient of the Granville Lions Foundation Award, the Hyman and Anna Berkowitz Scholarship, the New York State Education Services Scholarship for Academic Excellence, the Printing Plus Salutatorian Award, and the Stanley and Betty Godlewski Memorial Scholarship. Zoe Page. Zoe is a recipient of the Ada B. Lori Endowment Fund Award, the Blue Shield Scholarship, the Brian Tressler Memorial Award, the Douglas Prize, the Granville Rotary Club Louis D. Goldberg Memorial Award, the Jesse Jordan Memorial Award, the Manchester Newspaper Award, the Modern Woodman of America Award, the Sheldon Slate Products Company Incorporated Valedictorian Award, the UVM Green and Gold Scholarship, and the Vermont Honor Scholarship. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Please help me in welcoming Valedictorian Zoe Page.
It is with great pride that I say, welcome to the class of 2017, to our teachers, parents, family, and friends. For the past 13 years, this class has been cultivating something unbeknownst to ourselves. It has become the driving force for our decisions and the reason we are willing to take risks and to try something new. This something is a support system second to none. Our support system, rooted deeply in love, includes parents, grandparents, family members, teachers, and friends. It is these people who have helped instill the confidence for us to develop and vocalize our dreams. I am neither old enough nor wise enough to give you any advice on how to take on your future, but I think I can speak for all of us in saying thank you to all of the people in our lives who have believed in our ability to succeed at anything we put our minds to. Belief in oneself is key, and hearing this message is a gift given over and over by those who love us and believe we will achieve great things in life. Over the past few months, I have taken the opportunity to sit back and marvel at the composition of this class. It has only been in these past few months that I've truly realized how utterly diverse and talented is this class of 2017. We have all-star athletes, state qualifying wrestlers, world qualifying VEX robotics team members, musically and theatrically gifted people, tech-savvy people, gifted artists and dancers, those with the ability to effortlessly comprehend calculus, and those individuals who have dedicated countless hours to serving their community. And I can't forget to mention our state FFA officer, Seth Bro. We also have classmates who will join the workforce and armed forces next year, and many of us who already have jobs. We have an amazing, talented group of people here, each of whom absolutely deserves to be celebrated. In the past several months, we have all been asked the same question. What do you want to do? Well, that really is the question, isn't it? How do we plan on harnessing all of this potential and all of this talent to make it mean something? If we asked Mr. Harden this question, he would most likely respond, use your best judgment. But sometimes that's not enough. I think that oftentimes this question is posed through the lens of your particular passion. But I believe that to answer this question at this point in our lives is nearly impossible. Sometimes the best answer is the honest one. I don't know. But following this I don't know, we must prepare to embark on the journey of finding out. We have been given the gift of a solid foundation, one which has and will allow us to explore anything and everything we put our minds to. We are entering into a time of self-discovery, and the most vital part of this process is going to be exploration. I mentioned the impressive and diverse talent which this class possesses, but these talents have not been discovered without the elimination of activities that haven't brought us fulfillment. This is a process that has involved some degree of failure, which goes hand in hand with exploration. J.K. Rowling once said, "It is impossible to live without failing at something unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all, in which case you fail by default." If we live in fear of failure, we may never discover our passion or purpose at all, because our failures and successes alike are both stepping stones to the discovery of our purpose. And we know with certainty that those who love us and support us will be present for both. There is a poem written by Shel Silverstein called The Giving Tree, which many of us may be familiar with, and some parents may remember reading to their children. The poem is about a tree who loves a little boy. The tree would say to the little boy, "Come, boy, climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy." The boy would begin to make her leaves into crowns, swing from her branches, and play in the shade. But as the boy grew older, he matured beyond these activities, which no longer made him happy. So the tree told him to take her apples, sell them, and buy things that would make him happy. And so he did. And the tree was glad to have helped the boy. When the boy returned, the tree said again, "Come, boy, climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy." But now the boy wanted a wife and children. So he needed a house. So the tree told him to take her branches to build a house. The boy built his house, and the tree was happy to have helped the boy. The boy returned after a very long time, and the tree said, "Come, boy, climb up my trunk and swing from my branches and be happy." This time the boy was sad. He wanted to escape. So the tree gave the boy her trunk to build a boat and sail away. And the tree was willing to give the boy her trunk, but she was not happy because the boy was unhappy. But then the boy returned a final time. The tree had nothing left to give. She was nothing but a stump. She apologized, wishing she had something left to give the boy. All the boy wanted was to sit down and rest. So the tree invited him to rest on the stump, and the tree was happy once more. The support, love, and patience we have been given is very similar to the boy in the tree. Our parents and teachers have instilled so much of their knowledge, kindness, and faith in us, providing us with every tool we need to be successful in our futures and acting selflessly to ensure that we are successful and, above all, happy. They have been so willing to put us before themselves, and we can be assured that they will continue to do so even in the face of adversity. So, as we go forward and begin our odyssey of discovering our happiness and our passions, we should remember two very important things. First, remember the story of the boy and the tree, and know that our gratitude and the discovery of our own happiness are the greatest gifts we can return to our families, teachers, and community. And second, remember the words of poet Maya Angelou, who once said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." So, to the class of 2017, be confident in the knowledge that sharing a fraction of the kindness we have received will have a ripple effect in the universe. Congratulations, class of 2017, and thank you, parents, grandparents, families, teachers, and friends. We could not have done it without you. I wish you all great success and happiness in your futures, and I am beyond excited to see what amazing things we will accomplish. Thank you.
If we could go ahead and have the class officers come up and lead us in the alma mater, please.
I'm so proud of you.
That was awesome. Day.
All right, ready? Okay. Ready?
I'm gonna put my hand up.
Should we wait? Should we say, please join us?
Yeah. All right, no, let's just start it. Ready?
Ready?
Where the rippling Indian River joins the meadowee, there thou standest, alma mater, hail, oh hail to thee. Lift her standards high and higher, cheer with right goodwill.
Please help me in welcoming Board of Education President Audrey Hicks.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I'm honored to have this opportunity to represent the Granville Board of Education. Zoe, I may be old enough, but I'm not sure I'm wise enough either. I have attended many graduations as a student, as a faculty member, and as a parent. In all three roles, I have one common memory, trying to stay focused while entertaining thoughts about the celebration that would follow. So I hope to capture your attention with an interesting historical fact. 200 years ago, in 1817, a petition was presented in the Boston Town Meeting calling for the establishment of a system of free public primary schools. Main support came from local merchants, businessmen, and wealthier artisans. Many wage earners opposed it because they didn't want to pay the taxes. So the public education from which you have benefited has come a long way over the last 200 years. However, our desire to pay taxes, not so much. Well, enough about history, now about your future. I would like to share some thoughts with you that I hope you will take to heart as you embark upon your next adventure in life. Graduation is a time of change, moving from one phase of your life to another. While change can be exciting, it may be challenging or even a bit scary. Last year, I encouraged the class of 2016 to make a difference in the world, reminding them, because their actions have consequences, they will need to make wise decisions. While I encourage you to do the same, this year I would like to address change from a different perspective. What do you do if the changes you are facing are overwhelming? How do you break these changes down into manageable pieces? What if you need help? To whom do you turn? Now, at the risk of crossing the line of what can be addressed in the public school setting, I would like to use one of my favorite prayers as the basis for this speech. First, let me make the disclaimer that While I personally address this prayer to a higher power I choose to call God, you can choose any power larger than yourself on whom you rely for help. A person of authority, a natural phenomenon, or the love of your family and friends. With that being said, the Serenity Prayer reads, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. So let's look at the Serenity Prayer one line at a time. The first line states, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change. Facing change and or trying to make a change requires acceptance of what you can and cannot do. It also requires being at peace with your limitations. For example, in anticipating this graduation, whether it will be held outdoors or indoors, is dependent upon the weather, which is always out of our control. You could have worried about this or have been upset by it, or you could have accepted this fact, become at peace with it, and decide to make the best of graduation regardless of the weather. I think you're doing that. The second line states, grant me the courage to change the things I can. Making a change requires the courage to do things differently or to stand up for what you believe in the face of pressure to do otherwise. If you've decided to go into the military, for example, while your closest peers are going off to college, you are following your conviction to serve your country at this time in your life. This takes courage on many levels. And finally, the last line asks to grant me the wisdom to know the difference. Knowing the difference between what you can change and what is beyond your control requires the wisdom that comes from experience and by thoughtfully considering the desired outcome and its consequences. For example, you may know someone who is in debt from college loans. This experience may lead you to go to a community college for part of your undergraduate experience or to go into the workforce before entering college in order to save money. So as you go out into the world, whether into college, the military, or the workforce, remember, there's no shame in asking for help from supervisors, from friends, from family, or from a higher power in which you believe. Assessing what is within your control and finding the wisdom with which to make each change will make the challenges before you less daunting. So may God grant you the serenity to accept the things you cannot change, the courage to change the things you can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Congratulations to the class of 2017, and God bless you all.
Okay. 71-year-old Walter Buddy Hughes will graduate with the class. Mr. Hughes was drafted by the Army his senior year in January 1963. He went to Vietnam upon his completion of basic training. And when he left the Army, he joined the U.S. Navy Seabees, from which he retired. Mr. Hughes is a life member of the VFW Post 1653 and a member of the Granville Fire Police. And ladies and gentlemen, it is with great honor at this time that we recognize and present a diploma to Mr. Walter Buddy Hughes. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my privilege to present to you our graduates.
What's that?
Jonathan James Amaral. Benjamin Andrews. Stephen C. Baker.
It's okay.
Adam John Ballard. Colt William James Ballard. Rachel Elizabeth Bartholomew. Sabrina May Bishop. Tyler Edward Black in absentia. Scott Bogart. Trace A. Bourne. George James Bork. Seth Matthew Bro. Lauren Elizabeth Buschero. Jeremy Jordan Birch. Alexander J. Burrows. Alexis Stacia Carroll. Matthias Christopher Kyriopoulos. Christina Marie Chilcott. Jonathan W. Cleveland. Natasha Catherine Eileen Cooper. Jacob R. Corlew. Chasley Rihanna Cozy.
Yes, okay. Congratulations. Thomas James Covino. B. Bailey Edward Daigle. Matthew Daniel John DeAndrea. Luke Pontiac David. Ryan R. Decker. Brenda L. Devino. Jeff Aaron Dufour. Jamie Lynn Dunbar. Matthew Dundon. Cameron M. Duval. Adam A. Edwards. Nicholas Tate Edwards. Jarrett Warren Atori. William Joseph Figueroa. Matthew Fuller. Paige Charlene Gardner. Haley M. Godet. Dawson C. Goodspeed. Carly Brooke Goodspeed. Abigail L. Gordon. Erica L. Harwood. Olivia Lynn Haskins. Jody Lee Hermance II. Becky Lynn Hinton. Gabriella Ryan Hunt. Alexis Lee Jones. Michael Dean Jones. Max David Juckett. Richard Lauren Kelly III. Kiara Marie Kelly. Nicholas Kotrakis. Timothy Mark Cram. Michael Trask Liebig. Aaron S. Mackey. Sydney Paige Martell. Marissa Irene Martell.
Well done.
Raymond Roy Martindale III.
Well done, Ray.
Kyle Edward Madison. Darren Thomas McKittrick. Stephen M. Monroe in absentia. Sierra Elizabeth Muse. Robert Kenneth Myers III.
Congratulations.
Cheyenne C. Oakman. Molly Isabella O'Brien.
Well done.
Caitlin Marie Paddock.
Well done.
Zoe Ann Page. Hollis Michael Paquette. James J. Polakowski III.
James.
Laura May Pearson. Heather E. Petty. Mariana Pitnerova.
Congratulations. Let me go down now.
Asia Lee Reese. Jared Michael Renaud. Gordon J. Rescott. Avery Parker Roberts.
Congratulations.
Sophia May Scott.
Congratulations. You're welcome.
Contessa Alexis Saliski.
Congratulations.
Alexis Nicole Smith. Christiana Lynn St. Marie.
Well done.
Lauren Marie Taylor. Brianna Mae Thomas.
Congratulations.
John G. Thomas III.
Congratulations.
Carlos L. Van Gilder. Morgan D. Williams.
Morgan.
Owen Scott Williams.
Congratulations.
Ward Oren Wilson. Jason Andrew Zoll. Dakota Scott Zellers.
I see.
Okay, thank you.
That's good. Would the graduates please stand? Mrs. Harrelson, have all of the candidates for graduation met the requirements set forth by the New York State Education Department and local regulations?
Yes, I have.
By the power vested in me as president of the Granville Board of Education, I hereby declare you the 2017 graduates of Granville Central School. Congratulations.
If you'll lead us out in the recessional, please.
No, they just go.
we're supposed to... I know, they're supposed to start.
Stranded with a flat tire. I opened the Geico app. Then, with a few taps of my finger, I beckoned emergency roadside assistance and a tow truck to my car. I invite you all to unleash the full potential of your fingertips with the Geico app. Thank you.
In Pennsylvania, happiness has always been our keystone.
Life, liberty,
and the pursuit of happiness.